morning, honourable ministers. Good morning, friends, and welcome again to Rwanda, because I didn't welcome yesterday. Honourable ministers, captains of industries, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, it's a great pleasure to speak to you today at the opening of Innovation Africa 2014. I bring the good wishes of His Excellency Paul Kagame, the President of the Republic of Rwanda, who, as you might know, is a strong advocate for the use of ICT for development in Rwanda and worldwide. Please allow me to extend my gratitude to my colleague ministers, to the government officials and executives of technology companies for attending Innovation Africa here in Kigali. Many thanks also go to John Grace, the AfricanBrains team, and the Rwanda Ministry of Education team for a well-organized conference. Ladies and gentlemen, ICT has been chosen by the government of Rwanda as one of the key enablers that will achieve Rwanda's vision of economic growth and social development. This strong focus on development of ICT in Rwanda is targeted to be enhanced by additional focus on making Rwanda an ICT hub in the region. The commitment of the government of Rwanda to the development of ICT in support of Rwanda's development objectives is demonstrated by the leadership of the President of Rwanda, His Excellency Paul Kagame, who is a co-chair, as was said yesterday, of the Broadband Commission, and has won many international awards and recognition of his leadership and dedication towards promoting ICT development and broadband connectivity as a means of achieving sustainable development. In October 2013, Rwanda hosted the Transform Africa Summit. This meeting culminated in the establishment of a Smart Africa Manifesto with the intention to consolidate what has been achieved so far and adopt a smarter way of doing things. The overall target is to bring about a quantum leap through innovation and private sector-led development. As a result, Rwanda is now developing the Smart Rwanda Master Plan, which will oversee the final phases of the national ICT strategy, this time from 2014 to 2020 and beyond. The Smart Rwanda Plan is based around seven main themes: smart education, smart government, smart health, smart business and industry, smart agriculture, smart finance, and smart national information security. And three enablers, mainly smart ICT capacity, smart ICT governance, and smart ICT shared infrastructure. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, Rwanda Vision 2020 targets are to transform the country from an agricultural-based economy into a middle-income, knowledge-based society using ICT as an engine for development. Since the year 2000, the government of Rwanda has established institutions and mechanisms to create an enabling environment for the ICT development, deployed world-class infrastructure, and is continually developing a skilled human resource base in its quest to become a knowledge-based society and a regional ICT hub. An example to mention is a 4,500 kilometer world-class fiber optic backbone network, which has been constructed by both the private and public sectors. This is connected to two East African submarine optic fiber landing points, one at Mombasa in Kenya, and at Dar es Salaam in Tanzania, thus connecting Rwanda to the rest of the world. A national data center which can accommodate advanced technologies such as cloud computing is also operational. In addition, a project is being finalized to provide the last mile access for the broadband network using 4G LTE technology. It is targeted that within 3 years, 95% of the country will have access to high-speed broadband, which will serve to strengthen e-governance, business efficiency, and access to schools, health centers, local government offices, and to businesses and citizens throughout Rwanda. At the higher education level, a research education network called RedNet is being established to link all Rwanda institutions of higher learning nationally. Rwanda is also a founding member of a regional research and education network of Ubuntu. I'm sure quite a number of countries here are. Ubuntu is connected through giants in Europe to the global research and education networks. This will enable our higher learning institutions to share knowledge and research, including e-journals, e-learning resources, and research collaborations. As you witnessed yesterday, we are so delighted to have established the Carnegie Mellon University in Rwanda. This is designed to help spur the economic development of Rwanda through the attraction of the foreign companies to invest in Rwanda, partake in high-level research projects directly related to the needs of the region, especially mobile technology, to support the creation of knowledge-intensive jobs in Rwanda and the region. Ladies and gentlemen, we do recognize that in order to achieve our vision, it's essential that we ensure all our children that are able to access ICT technology at a very early age. We are delighted, therefore, that we are one of the foremost countries to have adopted the One Laptop Per Child project, which is ensuring that our primary age children, when they are older, are able to participate fully in computer-related skills, such as programming, data analysis, among others. Rwanda also finalized and signed a contract with Positivo BGH Group to invest into an assembly manufacturing plant to further accelerate the acquisition of advisors in Rwanda and in other countries willing to move at a high speed. The first productions of these ICT gadgets will be in March. To date, we have distributed over 204,000 laptops to more than 400 primary schools in Rwanda. This year, we distribute another 100,000 computers to primary schools. 5,000 teachers have been trained in basic ICTs, a methodology of teaching using technology, and 200 of the schools have been equipped with 1 terabyte server, digital interactive courses in maths, science, English, and the wireless local area network. But we believe there is a long way to go in this, especially in training teachers and deploying some of these technologies. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, there are many other initiatives which have been introduced and developed in Rwanda to ensure that the development of ICT capacity and capability in Rwanda to spur Rwanda's ambitions towards a knowledge-based society to become a reality. We are ever looking forward to developing and strengthening our partnership with many of the countries and companies here present. Partnerships could include areas such as 1, collaborations and investments in the technical core currently being established in Rwanda. This will act as an ICT city that will host a collection of technological investments, including training, industries, research, and development. 2, joint collaborations to ensure that appropriate technologies can be developed and deployed at secondary and higher education levels. Three, to work together to optimize the design and deployment of smart classrooms in schools at all levels of education to maximize the effectiveness of teaching and learning using the latest technological innovations. The strengthening of our partnerships can ensure that we can jointly work together to help achieve our common aims for the use of ICT for people's social economic development. Finally, ladies and gentlemen, it's my great honor to declare Innovation Africa 2014 open. I wish you all great deliberations. Thank you.